What's up, everybody? I'm Kelithia, and welcome back to the Mortuary Assistant. So we're starting back from the beginning, ladies and gentlemen. All the way to the beginning.
I'm so glad it's almost over. Congratulations, sweetie.
Thank you.
I'll never understand why you chose such a macabre field.
There's nothing disturbing about it. It's just that
I'm proud of you. I really am. You've come so far. So, you haven't told me what's next. Will you get a job where you are, or...?
They actually have everyone they need. But my old teacher, Mr. Delver, transferred me to his office to finalize my internship there.
Oh, well, that's good. I remember you mentioning him. Where's he located? Are you moving away from me?
No, I'm not moving. He's actually located around here. River Fields.
Oh, Rebecca... I don't like that.
Grandma...
Even I've heard things about that place. I'd just be worried
people
about you.
People make up stories. Death is a scary thing to a lot of people. And we try to explain things we don't understand, and we want comfort when we lose someone we love. I mean, no one's embalming any ghost bodies or whatever. It's fine.
Right, right. I'm sorry. But I wanted to give you this anyway. So, here.
I don't know if I want that.
Just take it, please. It should be yours anyway.
Thanks.
All right, enough spooky stuff. I'm so proud of you. When is all this happening? When do you start?
I've actually been there for a few weeks now. My review is tomorrow. Here we go.
Let's go. All right. So, to start with, we are going to do one of the achievements called throw the vase. And then another achievement is to flush the toilet. That's supposed to give us an achievement as well. I don't know why it's not coming up. We'll probably do it after. We've already read through that. Let's grab the pencil. Alright, let's go. I'll skip through this process.
Rebecca, great. Perfect timing. I just finished with Mr. Dalton here. Please wheel him back to cold storage and bring us Mrs. Page.
Alright, so... the first achievement is my first body. And it involves us just going through the tutorial. Game. Okay. Three marks. Alright. Let's give you a look-see. Alright. We got Dorothy Page.
You'll die here.
What was that?
I didn't say anything. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Sorry.
And spooky. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is
Tell
how
you
get the...
What?
Why don't you go ahead and head out? I'll take over from here.
Are you sure? I just got here.
Don't worry. You're doing great. I'll get the last of your paperwork sorted today and call you in for your first shift.
All right, Mr. Raymond. But yeah, with that, that is the first achievement, my first body. It's literally just completing the tutorial. And I showed you another one of the achievements, which is just throwing the vase. So we got two achievements down.
It was just really weird.
So some stuff fell over. That's not a big deal.
No, I know. It wasn't even my fault, but he sent me home right after that. I'm just really worried. He was supposed to finalize my stuff today.
And he said he would, right?
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Yeah, it just didn't feel like he meant it. Like, he just said it to get me out of the building. Wait a sec, I have another call. Hello?
Hey, Rebecca. It's Raymond.
Oh, hi, Mr. Delver. Look, if I did anything wrong today, just...
No. I wanted to apologize. You've done a fantastic job. I'm just not feeling too well. That's actually why I'm calling. I know it's late, but we just got 3 new cadavers, and no one else can make it in right now. I was hoping you could come in and take care of them.
Well, yeah. Are you sure? I mean, of course.
Excellent. You are doing me a huge favor. I took care of the rest of your onboarding. We're all set. And your new badge is in your personal belongings drawer in the back room.
That's great. Thank you. I'm on my way right now. I hope you feel better.
Thanks again. I'll see you tomorrow.
Bye. Holy shit! That was him. He signed me on. He needs me to come in tonight.
See? I told you it was fine. Congratulations.
Thanks. I have to go, like, right now. I'll talk to you later. Where are my keys?
Alright, and another achievement is, I think one of the secret ones, is you listen to all of the audio clips of the radio station, which I will cut in right now.
I'm Mr. Two Shades. Yeah, and this is the one song radio station. We're gonna play with this the one song radio station, because we're gonna play the same song, because it's all we have the budget for. I'm DJ Two Shades. This is DJ Two Shades again. You're still here. That's great. Play the same song again, because that's what we do. It's the same song radio station, still the same. DJ Two Shades again. This is the last time that I'm gonna tell you that this is the same song radio station. We're just gonna do the same thing over and over again. I'm gonna start saying the same stuff too, because it's just the same stuff over and over again. Same song.
Alright, and that is one of the achievements. You have to, like, I literally had this thing running for an hour and a half, and I just did something else while I was running it. But yeah, that's literally one of the achievements is that. But yeah, we got that achievement down. I believe it's one of the secret ones, like, they don't label it. Let me check just to be sure. Yep, it's one of the hidden achievements. I'm DJ Two Shades, is what it's called. Let us go!
Alright, guess I'll head to the back and get started.
10 out of 10, immersion. That's the next achievement that we just got. Then, of course, spooky Mr. Delver.
Hi, Rebecca.
Mr. Delver, I need help. Someone's outside the mortuary.
Just try to stay calm. I know you're scared. I'll unlock the door in a moment.
What?
This is very sudden, but listen to me. We have to start right away. I'm sorry. I didn't know until it made itself known this morning that it was here, let alone bound to you. I had no way.
Look, this isn't funny. Stop.
You need to take this seriously. You need to act quickly.
This is insane. I'll just leave. I'll just fucking leave.
You can't leave, Rebecca. I can't allow that for you or for others. It's far too dangerous.
What am I supposed to do then?
Most bodies I work with at night are fine. So we stay calm, okay? We embalm, file the paperwork, everything. Treat it like a normal day. Staying focused will help. I left some things for you on the desk. I'll call again when you get to the embalming room.
No, wait. Ugh, damn it, what the fuck? This is insane. Okay. This is so stupid. It's just some hazing for the new girl or something. Just play along and do your job.
All right. I don't think there's anything to read. Damn it. Just gonna make sure. Okay, we're good. Don't need to grab that yet. Hall key.
I'm fucking quitting tomorrow. I mean, who does something like this?
All right, listen carefully.
I'm sorry, but this entire thing is extremely unprofessional. If this is how you treat new hires, I don't think I can work for you. This isn't funny.
Rebecca, you don't have to believe me, but I hope you do before it's too late. The only way to save yourself is to banish the demon before you're too far gone. To do that, you will need to learn the demon's name, bind it to its chosen body, and burn it in the retort. Look, I know this is a lot to take in. I wish I could do more for you. I had years to learn what I know. You have hours. I've recorded a number of cassettes to instruct you in the hope that having a physical object with a known message will help you stay grounded. I won't be calling again. You can't trust the phones. Anything can be manipulated. Listen to the tapes. Learn the demon's name. Burn the correct body. The most important thing in the room is in that cabinet. Open it up. Good luck, Rebecca. I'm sorry this had to happen.
This is insane. Whatever. Just be the professional one, grab a body, and get started. You know what? Screw this. I'm calling the police. Fuck.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is another achievement.
Phone's dead,
I believe it's called. Let me just make sure that I got that name right. The phone's dead is the name of the achievement, and it's literally just at the start of the game, you try calling and it doesn't work.
The Night Shift Database, a computer program combining all my findings into one reference point. The database contains all the information on the process of expulsion, the tools used, and most importantly, all the markings of the known demonic names. If you ever forget what to do, replay these tapes or look it up in the database. The collection of demonic names is the most crucial piece to the puzzle. You will need this information. My ID card is in my personal belongings drawer. On the back is the passcode to access it. Use it.
Okay, that's the first tape. Let's grab the second. Oh, yeah, that's the third.
Yeah, screw all of whatever this is. I'm getting back to work.
To banish a demon to hell, it must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark.
Whatever.
Placing the
just
smaller pieces
grab
in the correct
body
configuration
will
spell the demon's name. Second, the bottles on the top shelf are a special reagent that will react to them. Add a
come
bottle
on,
to the embalming mixture during the process.
Lock me in here.
When the mark is
just
placed on the correct body with the reagent inside, force the demon to be bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it.
Finally, all right, let's check you out.
On the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They can be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Anywhere. The demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift entries to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture. Uncover the sigils. Build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort.
Alright, let's go get the other tape. Tape number 3.
At every moment, the demon is funneling its energy through you, weakening you, until you are unable to resist. Identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have. The closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information to guess its name.
Hello? Nope. New job. I'm getting out of here.
All right.
How long I went to school? New career path. Fuck this. Maybe. Everything's fine. It's fine. What? No, I... I'm just seeing things. I need to get back to work. It's fine.
Now, the next achievement is to go to the gate, try to open it. Then we go to the car, try to start it.
Oh, fuck. Oh, you're kidding me. I can't believe him. What am I doing? This is ridiculous. I shouldn't be out here. It's my fucking fault! Get back to work!
Demon gone? We're not done yet, though. We gotta do one last thing.
Not climbing the fence. I was that strange that it was so tall.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you get the achievement called No Way Out, I believe. Let me check. Yeah, No Way Out. That is literally that sequence. You have to go to the gate, then to the car, then to the wall, and try all of those things. And then...
I only have a choice. I'm stuck here. Fuck.
Or, the other achievement... I think this does require replayability, so it's simple enough. If you just reset after doing the first shift. The other achievement is if you go straight back to the room, and it's called I Ain't Afraid of No Ghost, and that's if, you know, you like try to go and then it's like, oh, you know, like it says to get back to work, and then you do actually get back to work. That is called I Ain't Afraid of No Ghost. So basically, if you just don't do what I just did and you just came back and started working again, that's what you get. Let me check if there's any more sigils. Nothing. Okay. Check down here. Nothing. Okay. Alright, so we've... I don't think we finished looking at him. Actually, can we play the third tape again? Ah, damn it. I'll just play it in a different one. Next achievement.
You need to file a copy up front.
Okay, calm down. Turbo. You push the turbo button on the computer, which is literally just pushing a button on the computer. And you get that achievement.
It's time to pinball.
Lady, you gotta calm the fuck down. And that, ladies and gentlemen, completing his body is how you get the first, or not the first, the next achievement, Flying Solo. It's literally just completing your first body on your own.
What are you doing here?
I miss you so much. I don't care about anything anymore. I don't want to be here without you. Please, just... I love you.
Oh, buddy, get me out of here! They're gonna kill me! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
Hello, demon.
You should have died when you had the chance.
I know there's stuff to read in this area, but if you haven't seen it, my recommendation would be go back to my previous videos, because I read it all in one of the previous videos. So if you really want to see it, it's in there. Again? I think it's her. I really think it's her. That's new. I haven't had that one happen before, and I haven't seen that happen.
You're wrong, you know.
I don't think I am.
This one. It's
thank you. I'll tell you which achievement this is once I see which ending it is. God damn it, it's so loud and annoying. Stop with the banging!
Good morning. It's nice not to be the one down there for a
damn it all!
Raymond?
I suppose a first name basis is in order.
So we got Let Me In as the achievement for this one.
It? Is it over?
For now. It's never really over. You've come a long way. It's a lot to learn.
I'm so glad I'm here.
I know it's disorienting. You'll get used to it. You should head home and get some rest. Every night can be different.
I think I'm fine.
Are you sure? You seem out of it.
Oh, I've just been waiting for so, so long.
What? What are you... Oh, no. You chose the wrong body. Rebecca!
Rebecca's not here, you fucking idiot!
You can see worthless. Watch your foolish boy and drink it as it melts from your pitiful frame!
We got the bad ending. My bad. Ending 3 of 5. Damn it. I could have sworn it was her. Fuck. Alright, well, we were wrong. Damn it. Alright, well, next shift. This time we're gonna go for speedrun and the speedrun is easy. Speedrun is just completing a shift in less than 45 minutes. That's literally it. And we're also gonna go for getting the correct body. Because that's what I was intending to do, but I fucked that up. So, here we go. If I don't get it this run, I'll just skip to whenever I do. Because the whole purpose of this is just for me to kind of like give you guys the scares and kill the boss. That was a pretty pathetic throw. Let me throw that again. There we go. Right outside. Close the door up. Immersion.
Hello?
Hello. Rebecca? Rebecca?
What the?
Why did you let me die?
Dad? Dad? Papa? Don't tell me this one's fucking cursed or something. God damn it.
This is all your fault. I regret every second with you. Time is running out, Rebecca.
Okay, there we go. At least we got something, some progress. Jesus. I was afraid it was gonna get stuck again and I was gonna have to reset the whole damn one.
I'm missing something.
Come on.
Yo, thought you'd be hiding in Billy's place. Your dad made a total fucking loser. Ran down to the beach in just a sec. Grab your kid and get down here. Party's gonna start without you.
Thank you.
Papa. Papa.
You did this to me. It's all your fault.
Dear Papa. Alright, let's get into that stomach of yours. All up in them guts. You're pretty quiet. Never mind. Okay, it's her. Alright, well, we know which one it is. Alrighty. Oh. So you were the one turning the lights off, huh? Alright, I get you're impatient. I'm getting to you. Let me just whip this guy around. So, you're the demon, huh? So impatient. You know, you could have just waited for me to get to you. But no, you had to be a bitch. But that's okay. I know it's you now.
Beastly of penitent, I will bathe in the blood of the righteous. All of man and country of sin. My coming shall herald glorious sorrow. I will claim the flesh of man for my own. 3 houses and halls of hell. 2 regions and glory of my house. 1 to usher tribulation. I have come.
Be more comforting.
Just let me get Rebecca. It will all be over.
Then. Hello?
Hello? I need to report a missing person. Sorry. Her name's Rebecca Owens. She's 14. She has a drug problem.
So I have that race.
I don't know. She was here at the house.
Slit your wrist.
I understand that. I need you to check them.
Hello? I need to report a missing person.
All right. I'll keep an eye out. Thank you.
She has a drug problem.
Right up there. I'm coming back. I'll be right back.
Hey! I found her! Down here!
Achoo.
here, Rebecca.
So, little Raymond thinks he found a replacement. Another sacrifice to save his fucking skin!
Come on, there it is. There's the key. Let me in.
Rebecca, it's me. It's your grandma.
Get out of here, lady.
I need you to let me in.
I need you to fuck off.
Don't you love your grandma?
I've already made this joke, but yeah, my grandma Bonnie. Not you.
It's so cold out here.
How about new?
Let me in, you little bitch!
That's just rude. Stay away. Fuck's sake, I forgot that she does that. God damn it. Scared the shit out of me. Bitch. Oh, I want another sign that it's her. I just want another. That's all I'm asking for.
Are you sure this is the right one?
Pretty certain. What the fuck? I don't like it. I don't like it. I don't fucking like it. Okay, no one's there. Makes me feel better than the last. Jesus, save me! Take the wheel. Jesus, take the wheel. Take it from my hands. My guess is it's her. I'm hoping I'm right because I'm tired of being wrong. This would be the third time that I'm wrong if I get her wrong.
I can't use that here.
It's getting real loud in here.
Right.
This won't fix
anything.
come on. Be right. Be right. Be right. Be right. Fingers crossed. Come on. Be the right body. Thank God, yes!
Is it over?
It's never over. But you survived.
Yeah!
What do you mean? Can I leave? I want to go home.
You can leave. But once an entity finds you, all the houses of hell will do anything to get back to you. I'm sorry, but it doesn't end here. From now on, there is always a chance this will happen again. No matter where you are.
I don't want this. I just want to leave. What do I do?
I'm sorry, but there's no going back. I've spent years learning everything I can to keep these entities at bay. It's the only thing we can do.
So what? You're waging some selfless holy war?
It's not a war. It's survival. And I'd hardly call it selfless. We're caught at the front line of something larger. But I don't do this for some greater good. We either face it, or fall to it. I wish I could claim to be someone better, suffering hell to save us all. But I simply want to live another day, just like everyone else. When I first experienced this, I had to make a choice. I could run and spend the rest of my days in fear, or I could learn to face it and keep some semblance of a normal life.
Normal. Right.
It's not a life I would want for anyone. But choosing between a life of fear or control. You're the first person I've met to face this hell and survive. So I'm offering you a different kind of job. Work the night shift. Learn what I know. Give yourself a chance at a life beyond. I don't know what you experienced, but I know it uses the worst parts of you against yourself. The more you experience, the more you'll confront the darkest parts of your life. But through it, you'll become unbreakable. I'm offering the tools to take control. The choice is yours. I hope you come back.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is ending 1 of 5. And that is also how you get the achievement, I Survived. Which is literally just beating the game the first time around. So, now that we've done that, we're gonna do the same thing again to get the next ending. Ending 2 of 5, that is. It's literally doing the same process, but it doesn't unlock an achievement. Unless you get it right within 2 bodies, but, you know, it's hard to say. How about no? I think it's you. I think it's you. The one time I go out of order is the time that something like this comes up. Of course it is. Last time I trusted that, I was wrong. I'm not doing it again. I think it's you. I think you're trying to throw me off. I really do.
Do the dead comfort you.
Typically. I would say no would be the answer, typically. I don't like...
What?
Stairs, huh? Get tubing by bed. Tubing used for restricting blood flow. Get needle from bathroom. Because that's sanitary. A hypodermic syringe used for injecting material beneath the skin. Find a lighter. Mix a small flame. Get spoon from coffee table. Bent spoon used for heating up liquefying for injection. Find full baggie on kitchen counter. Okay then. I'm sorry that I'm not very scared by this anymore. I've seen these things so many times. It just doesn't faze me anymore. I think it's him. Let me figure out which body it is, or not which body, which sigil it is. Actually, let me go get the match. The M, as I like to call it. M for Music's starting to get intense. I think I need to go ahead and burn him.
Are you sure this is the right one?
Pretty certain.
Thank you.
You've come a long way.
There we go.
It's nice not to be the one down there for a change.
Mr. Dover?
I think you can just call me Raymond at this point.
Do you always just pass out and wake up on the floor?
It takes a lot out of you. I've never simply walked out of here after. You get used to it.
I'll be sure to clean the floors better. Raymond, will this ever end?
I honestly don't know. I've been doing this a long time, Rebecca. I've traveled all over, learning everything I can. I've never found anything that could put a stop to it. So no, I don't think it does.
So, we're just like this forever?
It was hard for me too. But this is the life we get. We have to face our worst selves, constantly. But the better we know ourselves, the stronger we are. Why don't you head home? Get some rest. Who knows what's coming tonight?
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is ending 2 of 5. Now we'll go for the basement ending. So, because we're going for the basement ending, I'm going to go through in extreme detail how to get the right sequence for these things. First, we need to get this key here, because that's the easiest one to get anyways. Then, we go down here and go 1970-04. Oh wait, shit, I fucked that up. Okay, my bad, it was 1970-44. That's the code. My bad. Alright. Now that we've done that, oh goddammit, we'll answer the phone.
Hello?
Hello, Rebecca? Rebecca?
What the?
Now, let's go down to the basement. So you go out this door, around the corner. Oh, I forgot. Let me hatch key. This gets you, I believe, 6 feet under is the name of the achievement that it gets you. Yeah, 6 feet under. And now that we're down here, let me get back into the game. Come on. Mouse, please. There we go. Okay. So, I will let you guys read through this. And you can read through this.
I'm missing something.
Experiencing possession, the blood of the possessed will react to the name of the demon present. Injecting the blood of the possessed into a deceased body with demonic tendency will act as a reagent for revealing possession and form the foundation for binding the demon to the body. Then it can be marked with its name and burned. This should banish the demon. I'm sorry.
Now, we use the large old key to unlock this door.
Are you out there? Hello? Oh, I knew you'd find me.
Don't you hear me?
Why?
Will you help me get me the fuck out of here?
Oh, look at this. Who are you now? Yes, yes. Look at you, look at you, look at you.
Is Raymond here? Do you see what he's doing? Who could do this to someone? I think you should let me out.
Let me out, let me out, let me out. Tear out your
fucking eyes! I'm going to cut you open.
And stuff the burning embers of this fucking building, and you and Jake, you bet for death!
You'll be here soon.
Well then. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you get our secrets below. Or at least the, okay. Alright, I can't close the damn thing, so we're just gonna go around. Back inside we go. But yeah, now we just play the game as normal. Figure out what the body it is, and if we get the correct body, then we will get the basement ending. But that is how you get our secret below.
Every moment, the demon is funneling its energy through you, weakening you, until you are unable to resist. Identifying a demonic entity is a delicate balance. The further you are from possession, the more time you have. The closer you are, the more the demon will make itself known, allowing you the information to guess its name and the body it's bound to. The only way I've found to tell how far along a possession is on your own is to scribble on a piece of paper. Don't think about it. Just scribble. Look carefully. If you notice anything strange, it's starting to take hold. There's a notepad and a pencil on the desk in the front room. Checking from time to time can give an idea of how long. To banish a demon to hell, it must be bound to its chosen body and burned. The three objects in this cabinet are your tools. First, the clay tablet in the center is called a mark. Placing the smaller pieces in the correct configuration will spell the demon's name. Second, the bottles on the top shelf are a special reagent that will react to the mark. Add a bottle to the embalming mixture during the process. When the mark is placed on the correct body with the reagent inside, it will force the demon to become bound to it. Pay attention to signs that you have chosen correctly. They can be obvious or extremely subtle. Once you are certain the demon is bound to its vessel, burn it. Finally, pieces of paper on the right are called letting strips. It must inscribe the sigils of its name in our world to begin the evocation. You will need to uncover these sigils to use them. Hold a letting strip up while wandering the mortuary. If it begins to smolder and burn, you're close. When the paper combusts, the sigil has been revealed somewhere in that area. They can be anywhere. So look on walls, under objects, inside furniture. Demon will inscribe its sigils over time to try and hide them, so check regularly. Once you uncover the sigils, use the night shift database to decide which demon you're dealing with, and use that knowledge to create the mark. The steps are simple. Add the reagent to the embalming mixture, uncover the sigils, build the mark and place it on the body. Then, when you're certain, burn it in the retort.
Let's see how each person reacts to it. Alright, so we got no reaction from him.
It's
can't use that here.
God damn it. Let's get you put back in. Nothing? No reaction? Alright, we're gonna give you a look-see, alright? Oh! Oh, it's you! It's you! It's fucking you! Oh, God. I could've had it! Damn it! I could've had it. Oh, it was the first body I touched. Excuse you. Tis you, sir. You are the demon. Come on. Yeah.
Raymond.
I'm here.
I can't believe you. What you've been doing is monstrous.
I've said already that I've had to accept everything about myself, just like you do. This is a necessary evil.
It's sick. She's down there right now, just suffering for no reason.
Valerie is not down there. Not anymore. She's been gone for years.
You don't know that. You're just gonna let her stay there. You don't know what she's feeling. You are torturing her.
She's helping me survive. She's helping us survive. Without her, there's no reagent. Without the reagent, we have nothing. You wanna have a chance at life? It comes with a cost. This cost. You have to make a choice, just like I did.
What choice? Keep her alive to just bleed her over and over again to save ourselves? If she can't be saved, end the torture. I mean, she's down there suffering for your own gain.
My gain? My gain. You used her too. It didn't stop you from finishing the job. You used her blood anyway. When it came down to it, you chose survival. Just like I did. I can't kill her, Rebecca. I know it's the right thing to do for her. I know. But she isn't the only one.
What?
I've seen many experience what you did. None have survived. I've watched them degrade and suffer until they're no longer themselves. I didn't know what else to do. I couldn't just let them suffer. I searched for years to find a way to reverse it. All I found was the way to prevent more. Isn't that better than nothing? I've killed them all, Rebecca. It was the only thing I could do. So yes, I am a monster. But this one horrible thing has prevented me from having to take any more life. And I would choose that again and again. I can't live with any more death than I already do. I've made peace with it. The choice is yours if you can too. I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is ending 4 of 5, and we are going to work on getting number 5. By now, you should have the achievement if you're, like, following the same number of shifts. Eventually, throughout playing the game, you'll get another achievement called, All the Pieces. It's literally just experiencing all of the major story events. It's not the endings necessarily, it's like the scares and stuff like that. That's what they're talking about. But you should probably have that by now if you've had 5 shifts. Other than that, next up is closure and then getting the final ending and for us to finish up reading, because there's some like stuff with the night shift database that we haven't gone through, and doing that will help us significantly. Okay, so I was trying to figure out why I didn't get
the thing
before. The guide says some, like, there's 2 different guides that say 2 different things to get the closure ending. I know I got the closure, but I'm gonna try both things, and I'll show you what those things are. Okay, so that apparently has to do with the closure ending. So, hopefully, right? Am I right? Hopefully? Also, hopefully Dad shows up, because, you know, I would appreciate that as well, because I feel like that's also a part of the closure ending, but whatever, you know. We'll get there. Alright, but yeah, that's part of the closure ending. You can put the coins in her hands and that can get it, I guess. I don't know, that's what the game said. The guide. Guide said you can do that to get... Also, a different guide said the necklace. Which, that did work. So, I don't know, maybe both of them work? Maybe you need to get both of them to get the mortician thing that I'm trying to get. Which is one of the achievements.
Rebecca, come here. Come here now.
Get over to Grandma.
Mom. You stupid bitch.
Hate me all you want. He's dead because of you.
You should be the one here.
Lifeless.
Worthless. Wake up,
it's me.
How about a big fat nope on that one? You know, I don't really feel like giving you up my immortal body. Not immortal, mortal body. That's what I meant. Yes, I am immortal. And I don't want to really give that up. David White Whitlow. December 8th, 1949. May 8th, 1983. Wait, no, 1949 to, yeah, 1983. Dead and forgotten.
Rebecca, it's me. It's your grandma.
Fuck off, Grandma.
I need you to let me in.
No. You gotta stop doing this to me, man.
Don't you love your grandma?
Yeah, I do, but you can't keep showing up at work like this.
It's so cold out here. I have to come in. Let me in.
How about no?
Let me in, you little bitch!
Oh, there it is. I see it. Just barely, but it's there. It is him. He's the demon. bitch. You're just mad because I figured out which one it is. Huh. Maybe I missed that before. I don't know.
I can't use that here.
Yeah. Hopefully I still get the closure ending. And there you go, that's closure. That's the closure Dave, ending. Love. And the achievement that it gets
I'm
you.
Here. It's all right. You're safe.
Oh my God, Dad.
Hey, sweetie, it's all right.
I ruined everything.
No. My little girl, don't do this to yourself. You've suffered enough.
Mom.
You're not like her, Rebecca. Your mother. She gave up on life long before she died. What happened to me was the result of choices you should have never been exposed to. You changed your life. And I'm so proud of you.
You changed too.
Not before I heard you. Sweetie, you can't do this to yourself. Don't remember me like this.
I don't want to forget you.
If you relive that night over and over, you'll only remember pain. The best of me is in you, sweetie. I'm with you forever.
I just miss you so much. Every day I just... I don't know where to go without you.
Shh, I know. I know it's hard. But you know where to go. You've already found it. Souls are suffering, Rebecca. But you can help them. You can bring comfort and closure to the living. And let the dead rest. Let the dead rest, Rebecca. I love you.
Dad. I love you.
One single tear. Rolls down my face. Alright, Night Shift Database. The database is a collection of all my findings related to the banishment of covetous demons, the history of the demonic, and the tools I have found through my research, years of travel, and piecing together whatever relics remain have been compiled here. The navigation bar at the top leads to the following subsections: the history of the demonic, identifying demonic tendencies, sigils with demonic names, and tools to combat demonic forces. Path to banishment. Embalm each body with a special reagent from the cabinet. Use letting strips from the cabinet to attempt to reveal demonic sigils. Compare the found demonic sigils to the demonic names within the Night Shift database. Build the mark to match the demonic demon's name. Pay attention to each body for demonic activity. Note that bringing an already embalmed body back out to reinspect for changes may be necessary. Place the mark on the body believed to have demonic tendencies, I think it's supposed to be. Or tenacity? I don't know. Burn that body in the retort before possession takes hold. A collection of demonic history. Since I first experienced contact with the demonic entities, I have dedicated myself to researching everything I can to prevent their attempts of possession. My journal has taken me all over the world in search of answers. I have found that no particular religion has a full understanding of the demonic. While bits and pieces remain true in various interpretations, there is much that is inaccurate or simply unknown. I have compiled what I have found from various archives and relics. None of this is integral to banishment, but this knowledge may still be useful. Rediscover the language. Athenian text and language. Athenian is... Wait a minute, let me go back. Make sure I click the right thing. Yeah, Athenian text and language. Athenian is a long-dead language recorded to be lost in the burnings of the Library of Alexandria. Only a handful of religious scribes had known, knowledge of Athenian text and its spoken language. After the fires, what little was known was recorded and hidden to keep safe. Known as the ethereal language, it was believed to be the tool of angels to communicate with man. Few have been allowed to access allowed access to the remaining documents. Ethan and Antahean, demonic Ethan. Satan's exile from heaven and his hatred for God drove the creation of the desecrated tongue Anthen. Anthean. Antahean. Antahean, I think it's supposed to be. Its records had been combined with the remaining documentation of ancient Ethan in an attempt to discover more of the ancient language. Below the translations I could find. Format Ethan, Antahean, and translation. Some words simply do not have an Athenian equivalent, which is signified by N-A. So, Kophra means blood. Kophris or Kotish, Kotish is blood of sin. Vavum or Vavrish is vessel of flesh. Vicorphis or Vicotris, vessel of the blood of sin. Varash is vessel of holy water. Sinets or Sektish is sin. Fovum or Ferric is fire to burn. Sif or Ferisic is home. Siftu or Feriscar is house or home of. Hos is holy. Kohir is water. Hose or grav is to pray. Derit or derak is decay. Shaf or shadat is shadow. Reserve or teshiv is death. Memre or mokre is imitation, mimic. Osum or shakruk. Is human. Menef or Mukef is to create. Haran or Ukran is to arrive. Nain or Tain is name. Piran or Shunt is fear. Darium or Kosium is drink. Vu or Ku is you, yours possession. V or E is me, mine possession. Below are recordings I managed to capture of Antean being spoken from the mouths of the deceased and their translations. Kosim Kotrish Kue, I will drink your blood of sin. Grev Uken A, pray in my name. Shunt Ferescar, fear the arrival of my house. I forgot, let me go back. quarter letting. Oh, lovely. When the church found someone to be guilty of sin beyond the forgiveness of God, the accused could atone for their sins and re-enter the grace of God by undergoing a cleansing of sin known as quarterletting. A priest would bless the holy blood that remained in the sinner before cutting the wrist and allowed the remaining blood of sin, known as kophros, to flow freely into an urn. The blood would be drained when the accused became weak. Okay, the blood would be drained until the accused became weak. This weakness was believed to be the body being unburdened from the weight of sin. The amount was believed to be approximately a quarter of the sinner's blood. The kophros was then burned, as the blood was believed to be part human and part demonic. The halls of hell. The halls of hell. When Satan and his followers fell from grace, he forged from his throne a great hall. In this hall, three houses were built, and he gave positions of power to his disciples within them. These disciples were to covet the soul of all sin and gather them to bring destruction to God's creation on earth. They were given charge on the three great houses within the halls to build and command their armies, as archdemons of the devil known to humans as the covetous demon. Mark of the Three. In the Mark of the Three, the devil's hand is seen holding three fingers up, surrounded by the iconography of the different houses. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The lesser spirits. The lesser spirits. A demon's power are limited to that of their making. No one entity is strong enough to break into the world as a living on their own and must rely on other spirits to achieve this goal. The following are various entities whose purpose in the demonic plane is to act as tools to reach beyond the veil. These forces have many uses beyond those of the covetous demons and appear around the world where the fabric between the living and the damned is thin. The women in white. A fleeting manifestation of the House of Desolation, this entity has the power to have a more physically influential presence in the world. A covetous demon will form a bond with the spirit long enough to reach between worlds and perform its desired task by spying on its victims, attacking or funneling demonic energies to it to make them more susceptible to possession. The woman in white is only a partial physical presence, which it can inflict harm to the living. It is limited in its power and will dissipate quickly. The Shadow Man. A weaker manifestation of the House of Immolation, the Shadow Man is often seen as a guide, though it may be used to may also be used to spy on the living. A covetous demon may form a bond with the spirit to attempt to influence or confuse its victim. The Shadow Man is often seen standing out of the corner of the eye, moving quickly in and out of sight, or lurking in the shadows. The Mimic. The Mimic is a weaker manifestation of the House of Invidiousness, and is used primarily to view the living. The Mimic is the embodiment of the devil's envy of humanity. This manifestation longs to look as human as possible, but suffers eternally to only ever be a stiff, disfigured shell. What the true form of the Mimic is behind the shell is unknown. It has been recorded many times on closed-circuit televisions, often viewing the living only to vanish quickly when seen. Identifying the demonic tendencies. Oh my god, so much reading. Identifying demonic tendency. While learning the name of the demonic entity is more about waiting, identifying which body is experiencing demonic tendency requires paying close attention. While any of the bodies can be manipulated, it is easier for the entity to control its own vessel. Sudden movements, large or small, can be a sign of tenacity. If a body appears to be more active than others, or strange marks appear, it may be a sign of demonic tenacity. However, the demon is trying its best to remain elusive and may manifest these manipulations on other bodies, which is why it is important to take note of which bodies is experiencing these events. The more events linked to a specific body, the more likely it is to be a chosen vessel. The appearance of new marks in the body, sudden movements, large or small, repeat movements, is one body more active than others. Whew, so much reading. When a demonic entity is present, the vessel it is occupying may form markings not previously observed. Expecting a body additional times is important to spotting these. A body with a demonic inhabitant may display sudden movements. These movements can be as small as a twitch of the finger or as large as full body manipulation.
All right. This working? Yeah. This thing is huge. So, I guess, this is David. Raymond, this feels insane. Right. This has happened a few times now, but let me see if I can get in here. There it is. Fuck.
Yep.
Fuck!
Yep, that would be some demonic possession right there. We've already seen the sigils of demonic names. Tools to combat demonic forces. Alright, let's see it. Can you not? Tools of expulsion. An entity may be bound to its original vessel and that vessel destroyed in order to stop the process of possession. Throughout my work, I have managed to discover and establish a set of tools to bring about banishment of demonic entities. The occupied body must contain the reagent, the mark must have the correct demonic name, and the mark must be placed on the correct body and burned. Below are the tools I am aware of and their usage. The mark. The mark is one of two tools used to bind the demon in its chosen vessel. Each slot holds a sigil that represents a part of the demon's name. When all four are placed in the correct configuration, place the completed mark of the vessel on the vessel, believed to have demonic tendency. The mark will react to the Bafor reagent inside, binding the demon to it. Once the demon is bound, burn the body. Uncovering the demon's name. The evocation can only be completed once the demon has inscribed the four sigils of its name into our world. They are hidden from us until revealed by the burning of letting parchment. Once all four sigils are discovered, the name of the demon will be known and the mark can be built. Baleful reagent. The reagent is the second part of the tool used to bind the demon to its chosen vessel. It has a unique ability to react to the mark with the demon's name. Since it is unknown which body the demon occupies, it is important to add the reagent to all the bodies being embalmed. This ensures that once the mark has been built, any of the bodies will be ready to receive it. The demon will do whatever it can to breed doubt, so it is unlikely, though not impossible, that any noticeable changes will occur once the mark and reagent are in place. The choice of body and demon must be certain before burning the body. Letting parchment. The demonic evocation can only be completed once the demon has inscribed the four sigils of its name into our world. They are hidden from us and must be revealed. Letting parchment or letting strips are special pages of scripture marked with calling symbols and Athenian effects that will cause the demonic sigils to burn into our worlds well near. Okay, to use letting parchment, simply hold a strip up. As the demonic sigil is approached, the paper will begin to smolder. The closer the parchment becomes, the more violent the reaction will be, and it will burn. When the paper combusts completely, the sigil is revealed, and the area must be searched. Now, goddammit, I don't have the thing. How we looking? Oh, we haven't even. Okay, well, you know what? I'm just gonna throw a body into the thing and just, you know, get done. Let's go. Get this bad ending. Or, I mean, game over, technically. Game over.
Mr. Delver?
And just like that, that's the final ending, the game over ending. Alright, I don't know why I'm not getting the achievement for it, even though I literally did what they said, but that's how you're supposed to be able to get the Mortician ending. Even though for some reason I haven't unlocked it, like I can check again and it's like, wait, no, I did. I got it. Okay, it just didn't show up. When does it say I got it? Where's it at? The Mortician. What? Yeah, I literally just got it. It just didn't show up. Okay, so I did get the Mortician. Okay, so that's how you do it. Basically, to give a recap from the beginning, to get the endings at least, you do the correct body, then you do the correct body again. Those are the first two endings. Ending 3 is getting the incorrect body. Ending 4 is the basement ending. Make sure that you see the demon in the basement so that way you get that ending too. And number 5 is to do, to get closure, which is to either put the necklace on your dad's neck whenever he's on the table instead of the body that you're actually embalming, or to put the coins inside your hands when you're hanging in the hallway. Either one will work to get that ending. And then the final one that doesn't show up down here is literally just to burn the wrong body, but like really early. Like how early I did it, where I literally scribbled. There was no possession happening. I was just scribbling on a piece of paper and then went into the room, burned a body, and then the screen went blue. Whenever you get that, that's the game over one, and that's what you want to be able to get the Mortician, which is all of the endings. Even though it doesn't show up as an ending, that's what you want. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. If you liked the video, leave a like, and if you want to see more from me, why not subscribe? And I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye!